finished prayer. I'm not so sure where I'm going.
So you got your wife right there now.
I'm on my best behavior.
All right.
Are you sure?
Thank you, Lord. Presence be here with us, touching us, ministering to us, comforting us, bringing peace to us, healing us, and bringing us closer to you. So we ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. The heavens declare the glory of God, and all of the world will join in praising His wonders proclaim. Oceans and skies, they lift up their voice, and all He has made will rise.
Bye.
Salutations, everyone. Shalom, shalom. There's a double shalom. The first shalom means peace. The second shalom means peace to your body. In other words, healing to you. Amen. Now, it's hard to believe that here on the island of Patmos, that there should be other people. I kind of got all dressed up for the holiday. Kind of like all dressed up in no place to go. Island of Patmos, no yeah. And I've been out here for years and years. And many, 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 many years. I haven't seen too many people at all. But you all must be in the same place I am. They couldn't kill you either. Did they try boiling you in oil? Did they try doing different things to you and it just didn't work out, so they exiled you here with me. It's so nice to have company. For the holidays. Well, anyway, here we are, and I had a lot of time to think here. Lots and lots of time to think. I'm wanting to write an account of Jesus' life. But you probably have heard that Matthew already beat me to it. And he wrote, telling how Jesus fulfilled all the scriptures, so he wrote to the Jewish nation. And all the lineage of David was there, and the worship of the wise men, and the, oh. And then, I wrote down a couple of words, thinking that I could start on something, and then I heard that even little John Mark, he's younger than me, and he wrote another one to the Romans, telling them all the works and miracles that Jesus had done. And so then I sat down again and I started, and lo and behold, I find out that Luke, the historian, the doctor, wrote of Jesus as prophet, as king, as priest. Did he have to take it all? What am I going to write on? What am I going to write on? Who can add to such great words? And then I remember Jesus standing in front of the huge menorah in the temple courtyard. It was so big. It was so big and so bright that it lit all Jerusalem up. From a distance, you could see a glow over the whole city. And he stood in front of that menorah and he said, "I and my Father are one." Amen. They could have stoned him to death right then and there. That would have been the end of it. But those words were booming. They were like lightning. They came through my head. That light that shone into the darkness of my mind, said to me, Oh, Jesus is God. Not many of us had thought that at that point. But oh my goodness, Jesus is God. And no wonder it says Emmanuel, God with us. Yeah. Anyway, then I remembered the words of just a few days before, where we were on the Mount of Olives, and he said that I am the light of the world. He that follows me shall not walk in darkness, but shall have the light of life. Then I thought, wow, Jesus is God, the creator, the one who said, "Let there be light." And this is what I would write. I thought I'll tell this story about how the Messiah God was the light of this world. I'm going to write the Gospel of Light. But how do you start the Gospel of Light? Matthew had all the kings, the star, and all that, and then Mark had all the wilderness, and all the miracles, and then Luke wrecked it all for all of us and told the whole entire story from beginning to end. How do you start a Gospel of Life? And then it came to my mind. No one had spoken about Jesus before he came to the earth as God in the heaven of heavens, and how he came down to this earth he created to bring light into the darkness of this world. So I thought, that is how I'm going to begin my gospel. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God, and the same was in the beginning with God, and all things were made by him. And then for the Greek logic people, I had to say, there was not anything made that was not made, that was not made by him. Everything that was made by him. And I had to say it three different times in three different ways so that they could not get logically out of it. That means without him, there would be, well, nothing. In other words, I had to say it this way, without him was not anything made that was made. It made sense to them. It probably doesn't make sense to you now. But in him was life. And the life was the light of man. I can feel it now. And although I was not yet born, I wasn't, I'm really young. No, I'm not young anymore. I've been out here too long. But I was not even born when Jesus was born. You know that? As a matter of fact, I was a teenager in his band of disciples. He had teenagers in his band of disciples. I was one of the 12 disciples, and I was not even old enough. Well, you know what I mean. I heard that in the season of darkness of the year, at the 25th of Kislev, at the time of Hanukkah, at the great feast of life, the light shined into the darkness. Amen. No, that did. And the darkness comprehended it not. They did not see it in the babe in the manger. They weren't expecting it to be there. They weren't expecting a carpenter's son to be a prophet. They were not expecting anything that was about to happen. Isn't God wonderful? He just surprises us at every turn. And there he was, the true light, which lights every man. Now, why does it say that? The true light lights every man that comes into the world. So we come into the world in his light. Somewhere along the line, we must walk away from it. Isn't that sad? For sin extinguishes light. He was in the world. In the world, even though it was made by him, the world knew him not. In the world, was made. The Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. And we beheld his light, his glorious light. You wouldn't believe how much he shone every day, how much light we felt every day to walk in his. You didn't want to walk away from him. You wanted to stay close to him. He was the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. And he came unto his own, and his own received him not, but as many, Jew, Gentile, born, free, male, female, as many as received him, to them he gave power to become the sons of God, even to them who just believe on his name. That's not an awful lot to have to do. Which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. Thus, I will outline my whole gospel and give the whole gospel, even in this short amount of verses, even if you only get through chapter 1, you get the whole message. Because I figure, you know, some people, that's all they read is one chapter, and then they put it there. But if they read that one chapter, they are without excuse. I remember the words that Jesus spoke to Nicodemus, and so I wrote them down. I decided to add them in. And this is the condemnation, that light is come into the world, and men love their darkness rather than the light, because their deeds were evil. For everyone that does evil hates the light and tries to run away from it. I have found that many people tried because I was with him and because I'm an apostle. And when I was out in walking the streets and ministering, some people would run in the opposite direction when they saw me coming because they didn't want me to see their darkness. But he does not, but he that does the truth comes to the light, that his deeds may be made manifest. So, that's my gospel, the gospel of light. Will you come to the light? In this season of darkness, in these darkest of days, will you come in from the cold and into his glorious warmth and light? Because even as he said to Nicodemus, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world. So don't run and hide. Come on. Come out from under your chair. Because he came that you might be saved. So this holy day, this holy season, I ask everyone, come to the light. Let the light enter your heart. Let the light shine from your heart into other people's hearts. I'm even going to quote from my brother Matthew as he wrote these words on the Sermon on the Mount. I couldn't do as good a job, so I decided not to put it in mine. He said, "Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven." And everyone said, amen. 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 Lord, we thank you for your glory and for your light, and that you want to put your light in our hearts, yes, that we might shine. Now, would you all turn your lights on, please? And would we please turn the overhead lights off? Some of them in the back, some of them in the front. And I heard from your pastor that you can keep these. This is your present for tonight. Maybe you were thinking maybe something bigger. But these gifts are for you to take home and place wherever you want so the light will shine throughout the Christmas season. Amen. Amen. Oh, Matt, we do have... Mike is going to come up and sing with me. You come up and sing with me every year, and you're going to bring your little thing with you.
Not this year.
Not this year?
Oh,
it's okay. I don't force anybody. I'll be here all by myself. Wait a second. Where's Loreline? Where's Loreline in heaven? Are they hiding?
Yeah.
Yes, they are. Are they hiding way, way in the back?
Right here.
Ah, okay.
Are they melting crayons?
Are they melting crayons? Come on up. Come on up. That worked.
You want to sit down?
Yeah, sit down.
Do you want the softball too?
Ah, no, that's okay. Thank you.
No, I gotta have some light.
Come on up, ladies. We're gonna help you sing. We're gonna sing some.
Got the card?
Somewhere.
You put the words on the TV.
Mm-hmm.
I'll look up there and read the words if I can't read it here. Holy night, holy.
1 John 1:5. God is the light. Jesus is the light of the world. The star on top of the tree, a Christmas tree, help us remember Jesus' birthday.
Yes.
When we see the star, we should rejoice to be glad. The lights on the Christmas tree show us that light is greater than darkness.
Yes.
Yes.
Let's pray for peace in earth. Let us believe in the goodness given out to all. Jesus is our Savior. And draw close to Him. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.
Amen.
Some of you might have been going through something. But let me tell you, what you've been going through is called a refiner period. It's to purge you from all impurity, from your mind, your body, and your soul. I am circumcising you, your body from your flesh, from your fleshy desires to spiritual desires. Why do you fight what's good for you? And you give in so easy to what's not. So don't harden your hearts to me. I am calling my children from the four corners of the earth. Do you hear me? Do you sense what I am doing? Spend time in my quietness, and I have a calling on your life. But are you willing to rid yourself from self? So, Father God, I ask you right now, humbly come to you right now. Less of me and more of you. As this year ends right here, Father God, you are speaking to a generation, calling us in deeper. into what you have called us to do. Father God, I ask you by the Holy Spirit, lead us and guide us and show us what you want to do as we meet you in that quiet place. In Jesus' name I pray this. Amen.
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 Thank you, Lord.
Thanks.
Whatever you want to say. Put them on the spot. We just pray your holy and anointing over every person in this congregation. And we pray, Lord God, that as we go out and we meet with unsaved loved ones, family members, and friends during this season, that their hearts would be touched by the light of Jesus Christ, shining through us and touching their hearts. Let them see the light. Let them desire it for themselves. For we ask this in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen. Amen. The Lord bless you. Don't forget that there are Christmas cards for you, whether you think there is or not, probably out there in the hallway. And next Sunday evening is New Year's Eve. And we are having a prayer service like you have never seen before. It's going to be a surprise. You are going to be blessed.
That's at 6.
That's at 6 next Sunday evening. Amen. Amen.
No one will be falling
toward the ceiling. Not allowed.
He sent me the picture. Lord is a spiritual threat. There's prophets that live underground.
Thank you. But I don't know how different you really exist. This is
as a teacher, she's dealing with students, so I hope there's a resume to look for. They act one way and they don't act another way. So she's in this constant battle. She came to me last week. She was like, I saw the social skills from writing off her own work with student friends, and I broke my heart because. And then she flipped out at the end, she said, but since you didn't marry me, she's one of the women, she's like, oh, and I have students that are very, oh, hey, how are you, to everybody, everybody wants up there, hey, how are you, so, it's definitely a weird experience being pastor in an actual church, because today people just walk up and say, I can't take this, after the second one, I went to my senior, and I was like, you should have prepped me for this, but like, I can't take that, that's against my own concerns. And he said, don't you dare take away from the Lord's blessing.
Yeah, it's true. Yeah.
He was like, that's fine, so we're protected, but not.
Yeah.
So he's like, mostly Portuguese, Spanish, Haitian.
Oh, wow. Really?
Wow.
I think I go my trip down.
Yeah.
3 weeks in Africa.
Thank you.
What a blessing. Oh, unbelievably wonderful.
I'll send her your email.
Yeah.
Have a Merry Christmas.
You too.
Have a Merry Christmas, you too.
God bless, Eddie.
You are? When is it? Because a couple of the kids want to do it here.
I'm pretty sure Mom gave the info to
Judith. Okay.
I think so. But we're starting from fresh. How are you doing, sir?
Eddie.
I'm going to find out how high I was to go to the bathroom in these days.
I was so good.
No, you're good.
God bless you.
Good to see you.
Congratulations
Thank
on
you.
Your appointment.
Yes, it's wonderful.
Absolutely. Yep. Yes.
I got my interview is on the 22nd.
Yeah.
And then in April, I'll officially be a licensed minister under the DAG.
Yeah, it's awesome. Yeah.
It's
very exciting.
It is very exciting. The senior pastor is 38, I'm 30.
Yeah.
And so we're going to a place where people who have been there for 40 years have been like, we've never seen this before.
Yeah, that's awesome. That's awesome.
Board members have like come up to me and the senior pastor and been like, we've never had a vision to grab onto something before.
Yeah.
One lady was like, I've been here for 25 years. My kids were born into this church. We've never had a vision to grab onto. We've never had something to be together.
Well, and for the Lord to be doing a new thing.
Exactly.
Now it's happening.
Yep. So we went from, and this is no credit to me whatsoever, from 80 people when I started in June, we're averaging about 125 now.
Yeah, and then I heard there's a bunch of kids too.
Yeah, we have
about, all together there's close to 300 something. Your mom was here.
The most we had is about 200. Yeah.
200, yeah.
That's the most we had in one service.
Yeah, yeah.
We had a brand logo change. Like our new logo.
Oh, is it?
Yeah. Our Celebration International Church. And so
That's cool.
Old logo was a bunch of flags, which cost so much money to print.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So we did something simple.
Oh, all the colors. Yeah.
So normally it's teal and orange. And we had a Celebrate Sunday where we were celebrating people. We spent good money on like giving out shirts, giving out stuff for people to be like, oh, this is our church. And people invited brand new people, and since we got 180 in that event, 200 with kids. And since then, like, 5 families have joined the church since that.
That's great.
People have become members since have been pulling and, like, dragging their feet. So we're going in the right spot, but and then we have a food pantry that's, we're giving out like 1,500 pounds of food every week.
Oh, that's great. Yeah, that's good.
Are you in a tough area?
No. So the church, no. The people, yes. So we're in Waitlands, which is very, it's like a cave.
Yeah.
Very rich people, people who are traveling from Boston. But I live in Framingham. I've never seen a city that, it's culture to non-American culture. Like, storefronts are all in Portuguese. All the restaurants, like, you walk in, they go, what up? And you say, hi, they go, oh.
like, let me get somebody. But I made the comment from the pulpit. I was like, you know what's great about being right in this town is I'm the minority, and it's great because all the food is good.
Yeah.
So I made that from the pulpit.
That's good. That's good.
I have a,
everybody likes food. That's
yes,
good.
Exactly. So
that's good.
But no, it's, we're, we did a 10-year goal, and in our 10-year goal, we want to plant 2 churches, and we want to reach 30,000 people. So,
God, he can do it all.
Right, exactly.
So, I mean, I believe it. I think we're going to start seeing some shaking and moving, and I don't think it's, you know, we don't even know what it's going to be, but I believe the times are getting to the point where we're, you know, wow.
Yeah, I mean, I'm seeing the youth come to a place where they're like, we're tired of being overstimulated.
That's awesome.
And so, like, I have 3 students that I rely on for everything. One of them, I mean, she can win fine arts vocal solo. And you've known long enough how tough that is to do. She can win.
That's awesome.
And she's like, I'm going to go to Bible college. I'm going to be the pastor. I'm going to be a pastor's wife. And I'm like, hold on. There's so much more than that.
Oh, yes.
So,
oh, yes.
And one thing that's definitely been my very, I've been there 6 months. And I've hit on 2 topics over and over and over again because I kind of want this to be the backbone.
Yeah.
Is love.
Yeah.
What the Bible says love is.
Yeah.
And then second, we've been talking a lot, very traditional kind of international type of way, is we give the devil too much credit.
Yeah.
And so I've started saying it, and it's kind of caught on to like the rest of the church.
Yeah.
We're like, there are people that, oh, the devil are just attacking me. And I heard a lady last week go, watch your tongue. Don't give them. And I was like, ooh, come on. Let's have that, because we're doing things we've never done. Like, we did a trunk or treat on Halloween for the community. We had neighbors who never met us came up to us and were like, oh, this is amazing. Like, and we had one woman call us the day of saying, I can't believe you're doing something on the devil's holiday. Like, I can't believe we had a prayer meeting the same night. And I was like, I can't believe we're even having a prayer meeting. The devil's going to use that prayer meeting for his glory, not God's. And then my senior pastor, he's Portuguese. He's so, like, he's Brazilian. So there's, like, there's a little fire in him.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And so for 15 minutes, we sat the next week and we're like, listen, some of you came to me and talked to me about how we shouldn't be doing trunk or treat because it's on Halloween. But how are we going to reach those who have never been to the church or know
right,
who we are?
Right. And they only know that. They only know the Halloween business. They don't know the rest of it.
So that was nice that, like, we went out. We had 12 cars. We had 200 people show up. It was great.
That's awesome.
And then, so we have a full-size gym. It's a big building.
Yeah.
Honestly, my youth sanctuary is the same square footage as our sanctuary.
Wow.
I can fit 115 seats in that youth sanctuary if I want to. So it's a big building. It's a really big building. And we're able enough to, we have great retired, we call them our legacy members, who have poured into the Kidsmen. And so the Kidsmen, we were like looking at renting bouncy houses, and the senior pastor said, well, why don't you just go buy them for renting them for every single event?
Right.
So we bought 2 bouncy houses that were totally paid for, so we can let them pay over check for it.
It's smart, though.
Yep.
What I did last year, I don't know who the main, she's the teacher, I'm the assistant, but last year I really wanted the kids to learn to pray. Mm-hmm. Not just to say the words, but to pray for themselves, to pray for their family. And you know, all of them pray out loud now. None of them will stumble, or, I mean, they're not shy about it. And I love that.
That's good.
Because I didn't know about how to pray for people or anything, you know?
Yeah.
And that was really a big thing. but we gotta do it.
Yeah. So my next thing now is I'm in the fine arts like category of like using your talents for the
yes.
Lord.
Yes.
And then after that, we're gonna go into prayer, and then after prayer, leading into camp, we're gonna talk about the Holy Spirit.
Nice.
One of the first things I did there that the senior pastor loved was I wrote a 14-page guide on how to meet with this kind of problem. I hate that paper, but it was 14 pages. I came up with four things. Now, above our door, when we walk into the youth, it says all in. And so I encourage the students, I said, hey, even if you're not a sporty person, something like that, like sports players, when they walk down the ramp, they all get that same message. When you come into this room, I want you to hit the all in, because you're all into the Word, you're all into the Spirit, you're all into the community, and you're all in to Jesus. And I put it in that order for a specific reason, because biblical literacy is not big, so I want them to be all into the Word. I want them to all be listening into the Spirit. I want them to be all into each other, and then Jesus will be the centerpiece of all of that. We're getting there, but it is I'm still like, oh, I'm not a youth pastor, I'm an associate. And so having people walk up to me and be like, oh, pastor, I need this, and this. And being a youth pastor here and then in Missouri, I've been like, oh, well, go talk to this person. But now I'm that person. So it's very much like, pastor, I'm going to do this. But
yeah.
I'm getting texts that okay. I need to come home for Christmas dinner.
Oh, nice.
It's good seeing you.
Nice seeing you.
God bless.
Good seeing you guys. Have a
merry
Christmas.
Have a good Christmas. Thank
Let
you.
Let me know if you're in Wayland. I would love for you guys to see everything.
Oh, it'll be great. What's the name of the place?
Celebration International Church.
In what town?
Wayland.
Oh, Wayland, Mass?
Yep. So right next to Framingham.
Oh, okay. By Framingham. Okay.
Yep. Awesome.
See you guys.
God Bye. Bless. All right. I finally found what happened to Shalom, Jerusalem.
Yeah, what happened to
it? Oh, I put it in altogether the wrong place. And I had one more copy of it, and I'm thinking, where is that song? I finally found it. So it took me so long up here. So I just got to cover this, make sure the office light is off and the office is locked, because Pastor Matt was in there, and close this place up. So did you see what the low temperature was going to be the next couple days?
Yeah, like 44 tonight at the lowest.
Yeah?
Going to be in the 50s tomorrow.
Oh, and at night? I'm thinking about the whole thing. I'm thinking about...
Okay, let me look.
I'm thinking about going to the Wauquasin. I'm thinking about if I'm going to flip the emergency switch and tell people that the heat is shut right off in the sanctuary for now. If it's not going to be real cold, it's not going to matter. The heat can come back on Wednesday and I can find out when the guy can come here.
I was looking at a group text thing.
Oh.
Hold on.
It's okay.
Okay, so tonight low is 43. Tomorrow's high is 52. Tomorrow night partly cloudy, 41.
Ooh.
Tuesday 48, 41 overnight. Wednesday 49,
45.
So, not going to rain until Wednesday.
Right.
And it's not going to be freezing.
Right. I'm going to talk to the guy and find out if he can come here. If he's got the part, he can come here later in the week. Like, will we spend the night Tuesday into Wednesday?
Oh, I don't
know what night it is. The 26th, overnight. Yes, Tuesday, right? Into Wednesday morning. This is for us.
What is?
These, these, these. Down the hallway, I'm gonna go shut the emergency switch so the blower shuts off. There's no need, we don't, it probably won't even cool down that much in here by the time we come in here.
Can you get little light?
I'm gonna get those lights up front. You want green and red or just green?
Well,
the Bucks left one behind of it, so there's all these.
Too hot for me.
I'll finish up. I know it's hot.
little light of mine. I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine. I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine. I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine. Let it shine. Let it shine.
Amen.
Merry Christmas, everybody. Sorry for leaving the camera on. It's technical difficulties.